Today we are going to discuss about design of lead lag compensating network. So by this experiment we are going to draw the frequency response characteristics of a given lead lag compensating network. So apparatus required are decayed resistance box, decayed capacitance box, signal generator, CRO, probes and connecting wires. So this is the circuit diagram. Signal generator, we are having R1, C1, R2, C2. So R1, C1 are in parallel, R2, C2 are in series. So we'll trace out the connection for lead lag design. So phi m is minus 45 for lag, then for lead phi m will be plus 45. So by that we need to calculate R1 and R2. This R1 and R2 value we should put it in the circuit diagram. So this is my R1, C1, R2, C2. So R1, C1 are in parallel, red to red, black to black, right? Then from this it is going to R2, here it is connected in series. So this is C2 output terminal. Okay, so input signal generator and input CRO probe, I am connecting it here. One knob signal generator I am connecting here, another knob input I am connecting here, signal generator probe I am connecting here, then output here. Both here I had connected wire at the output terminal, so this here I had shorted. Okay, then output across R2, see here R2 which is in series with the capacitance, this I had connected. So regarding CRO, so input output, so input, this is my input, keep it for 2 volt peak to peak, then open output. Okay, then this is Lissajous pattern, press this Lissajous pattern, you will get curve. So for 1 kilohertz you will get a straight line. Then if phi m is equals to 1 kilohertz, frequency is 1 kilohertz, then you will get a straight line. If it is below 1 kilohertz, you will get this type of circle, and if it is above 1 kilohertz, you will get this circle. So what is this Lissajous pattern? How to take the readings from this? I'll just tell you. So ground it, so you will get a dot. Keep it in the middle, yes it is in the middle, then open that one. So how to take the readings? Okay, so that we are going to discuss now. So this is Lissajous pattern, we are getting Lissajous pattern. So this whole curve, that is your A, then here where middle line it is intersecting this point, it is B. So phi m is equal to sine inverse B by A, right? The whole curve, it is A, middle line intersecting middle point, that is B. See here, this whole 1, 2, 3, 4, so 4 blocks are there, so B is equal to 4, A is equal to, it is this point here to here, 1 2 2.4, right? So this B is 2.4, A is 4, so sine inverse of B by A will get you the phi m. Now what we'll do, we'll keep it for 1 kilohertz, then we'll check the, see, for 644 hertz, that is 0.644 kilohertz, that means 644 hertz
you will get this type of curve. Okay. Similarly, for 1 kilohertz, you will get a straight line. So above 1 kilohertz, right? 1.66 kilohertz. For this, you will get again curve. So for 1 kilohertz, you will get a straight line.
See here, 5M below 1 kilohertz, you will get some values. So for 1 kilohertz, you will get 0. That is straight line. Then above 1 kilohertz, you will get a bubble. Right? You will get a curve. Here 200 19 16 0.95 400 11 point, like that for 1 kilohertz, 0 straight line. Then again for above 1.2, you'll get some values. For 1, you'll get 0. Right? So this is the graph. 0 0.1 100 1 kilohertz 10 kilohertz. So it goes on increasing. It will be in terms of decade. 0.1, then here it will be 100 hertz, 1 kilohertz, 10 kilohertz, like that. So this is phase angle, magnitude plot, sorry, this is phase angle plot at 1 kilohertz here. This is at 1 kilohertz. You can see intersecting point. Sorry, this point, 0, no, this point, it is 1 kilohertz, right? So this is lag, this is lead. So 1 kilohertz below, you'll get some values, above you'll get some values. So by this, we can say that we can design lead lag compensating network and we can determine frequency response of a system.